what we found were about 10 genes. We always, of course, everybody always finds apolipoprotein E, which has been known for a long time. And then we found about 10 other genes. We've identified variants in these genes that are being inherited by cases more often than controls. That's basically what we found. We can look online and say, well, you know, in public databases and say, well, this is what these genes do. But we haven't proved that they actually do anything in Alzheimer's disease. So that's the next step, is to now go in, sequence these genes, and really find out what is the component in this gene that actually triggers the disease. I think you think of these studies as a big net that's been thrown out, and we've caught a bunch of really interesting things to pursue. The most important thing is that none of these genes are in pathways that we normally look at. So, you know, ApoE and all the other genes that we know about are all amyloid type genes. This gene, these set of genes, are in inflammatory processes and lipid processes. And then the third one is in intracellular trafficking. So that means that for late onset Alzheimer's disease, we have now four pathways that seem to be critically related to disease. I think what they do is they give us new targets. If even one of them breaks open a pathway that we haven't thought about before, that could have a huge impact. If this lipid pathway or if this inflammatory pathway turns out to be much more important in the causal part of this, those are targets that we could actually go after. So the good news is that there are some amyloid-based therapies that will probably help us get a handle on that. But that is based on the assumption that all Alzheimer's disease is related to deposition of amyloid. Now, clearly, that's an early and important event. The question that we're now sort of starting to ask, is that the only thing that's important? Have we been missing, you know, attacking the inflammatory system or the immune system or the lipid system or the intracellular trafficking system pathway, have we missed an opportunity because we didn't think about it or we didn't see it? And the fact that the genetic data are pointing us in that direction, I think, gives us a pause to say, well, maybe these are additional targets. You know, if there are now 10 genes out there, we're all likely to have a variant in one of those genes. So the question that we're just setting up to answer, if you inherit five of these variants in five of these candidate genes, does that mean you're going to get the disease? Nobody can answer that question yet. So that's the next set of analyses that need to be done. Like, how much of the risk of developing Alzheimer's disease can we attribute to each of these genetic variants? Is it cumulative? Do you need to have four or five of them? We don't know the answer to that question yet, but that's the next set of studies that needs to be done.